ಸುಮುಖದಯಾನಿದೆ ಶ್ಯಾಮಲ ಕರ್ಣ ಸುಧಾನವ ಸುಂದರ ವಾಮನ ರೂಪ ಶಿವಾತ್ಮಕ ಶುಭಕರ ಶ್ರೀ ಮಹಾಗಣಪತೆ ಸುರಪತೆ ಸಿದ್ಧಿವಿನಾಯಕ ನಮೋಸ್ತುತೆ ಶ್ರೀ ಮಹಾಗಣಪತೆ
Very good morning to all of you. I heartily welcome each and everyone for this 7th annual convocation ceremony of the CMR University. It is the time to honor and recognize the hard work of all our young friends who are very eagerly waiting for that proud moment of receiving their degrees, medals and awards. I am delighted for this opportunity to introduce our visitor, an exceptional political thinker, scholar and social reformer. He is also the governor of the Karnataka and first citizen of the state, Sri Devarachan Gelot. The honorable governor is from Ruptela village in Ujjain district, Madhya Pradesh. He received an honorary doctorate from Dr. B.R. Ambedkar University of Social Sciences. Our honorable governor was an agriculturalist and he deeply understands the problem of farmers and has worked tirelessly for their upliftment. As a trade unionist, he has represented the workers' struggle and contributed to their development in many ways. During emergency between 75 to 77 and between 1968 to 71, he was jailed multiple times for fighting for the rights of the workers. The Honorable Governor began his political journey with Rashtriya Swayam Sevak Sangh in 1962. He has had an illustrious and inspiring career as a Rajya Sabha member representing the state of Madhya Pradesh, member of multiple parliamentary boards and the Central Election Committee of the BJP also. The Honorable Governor serves for exploited and oppressed communities by working through a Balai Samaj, an organization that works against the social taboos by supporting the individuals that are the part of subjugated sections of the society. From 2014 to 2021, he was a Minister of Social Justice and Empowerment, where he drafted schemes to support and uplift disadvantaged communities. As an accomplished writer, he has contributed numerous articles in the quarterly published Madhya Pradesh Legislative Assembly. It is indeed an honor to have you among us, someone who has spent his life serving this great nation and its people. I extend a warm welcome to the Honorable Governor of Karnataka and the visitor of CMR University, who has graciously accepted our invitation to preside over this ceremony and confer the degrees to the graduating class. Thank you, sir. I am humbled and honored to introduce all of you to our esteemed chief guest, Sri Hari K. Marar, who has accepted our invitation to deliver the 7th convocation address. Sri Hari Marar is the Managing Director and CEO of Bangalore International Airport Limited, BIAL. He is responsible for the management, growth, and development of Kempegowda International Airport, Bengaluru, and its subsidiaries. In his current role, he recently spearheading the development of Kempegowda International Airport into a second largest airport in India through a massive outlay of rupees 13,000 crore capital. He is also instrumental in extending the second runway, second terminal, and the associated infrastructure and multi-modal transport hub. Sri Hari Marar is the chairman of Bangalore Airports Hotel Limited also, which owns the Taj Bengaluru and is developing another 775-room hotel in the airport campus. Hari Marar is also the chairman of Bangalore Airport City Limited, BACL, the company which is developing the airport campus into Aeropolis or an airport city that will be the home to multiple businesses such as IT parks, business parks, healthcare, biotechnology, knowledge park, retail entertainment, dining, and so many other things related to hospitality. Thank you, sir, for joining us this morning, and a hearty welcome to you, sir. A warm welcome to Dr. K.C. Ramurthy, IPS retired, former member of the Parliament, Rajya Sabha, and chairman CMR University and CMR Group of Institutions. In the late 1970s, Dr. Ramurthy began his career as a lecturer in economics, later joining the prestigious Indian Police Service in 1982. He worked in various capacities for the government of Karnataka, including roles such as Registrar of the Bangalore University, the Director, Kannada and Culture, Commissioner, Youth Services and Sports, and Inspector General of Police, Bangalore City. Dr. K.C. Ramurthy was nominated as member of the Rajya Sabha and as an active participant of the Upper House. He had tabled numerous questions and engaged in policy decisions spanning across the education and development. I welcome Dr. K.C. Ramurthy for this convocation, sir. Thank you. It is our privilege to welcome Professor Ang Yu On, the President, Korea National Sports University, Seoul, South Korea, and CMR University's awardee of the honorary degree of Doctor of Letters. We are honored to have you with us today. A warm welcome to you, sir. Dr. Sabita Ramurthy, the Chancellor of the CMR University, has been leading the university with her rich experience of over 30 years in education and building our organization to what it is today. I extend a very warm welcome to the Honorable Chancellor, Madam. It is also my privilege to welcome Sri K.R. Jaideep, Pro-Chancellor, Dr. Trishna Ramurthy, the Provost of the CMR University, and Sreya Reddy, the Director of Finance and Administration of the CMR Group of Institution. I extend warm welcome to all of them. I also extend warm welcome to Sri Jagannath Reddy, Secretary, and Dr. Raju Reddy, the Trustee. I also extend a very heartily welcome to all the trustees of the CMR Janardana Trust members, the Board of Governors, the Board of Management, Academic Council members, and various other statutory committees of the university who are all graced this function. I also cordially invite and welcome Pro Vice Chancellor Dr. Sanjay Jain, the Registrar Praveen, and Dr. Anil Kumar, who is our Registrar Evaluation, and the Finance Officer, Sri Lakshmi's, all other officers of the university on this august occasion. Thank you. It is my privilege to welcome all our graduating students and their parents who are always the part of the CMR family and the other distinguished guests, invitees and friends. I also welcome all the representatives of the press and electronic media. I would like to take this opportunity to share a brief report about the CMR University. CMR University has been established to bring the progressive education to the aspiring students of India. At our university, we work tirelessly to prepare our students for success by helping them to know themselves in their place in the community. We intend to make a difference in the world. CMR University offers around 73 programs under different schools and faculties of studies. This year, we have added 5 more centers of excellence, including centers of finance and finance technology, the data science, cyber security and networking, artificial intelligence and machine learning, and the Internet of Things. The CMR University student experience stands on 3 fundamental pillars: the program, the curriculum, the university common core, and the exciting learning, engagement, and advancement called as the LEAP programs, in alignment with the progressive vision of the university with the National Education Policy 2020. Interlaced with the program core curriculum, the common core curriculum are offered to all the students irrespective of their academic program that they pursue. Design thinking, which is one among the 100 plus core courses offered, empower students to think and solve the problems and come out of the conflicts. We celebrate Design Thinking Day, and an event has launched COST 2023, a global open innovation challenge, on March 17, 2023, which will see over 2,000 students from across many countries are participating. I believe this is a mega event. The mandatory community service launched during this academic year enabled more than 3,000 students to volunteer 17,000 hours of community service activities, which will show the commitment of the CMR University to the society. The LEAP, pioneered by the Office of the Student Affairs, is home to a strong student body and dynamic student council. Over 70 student clubs are included in the program. The annual events like leadership summits, Arohan, a marathon for a cause, water sports at Lakeside campus, beginning with a canoe club, are the identifiers of the students' enlightenment. The university has received several national and international recognitions, which include several awards, certifications, and more than 42 rankings at various ranking and branding activities. The innovation and partnerships saw 48 active MOUs, and 10 international universities are our partners as on today. Under the Directorate of Research and Innovation, CMRU has produced very high quality impact factor papers in the reputed journals of the university. Our students excelled in moot court competitions, and also they have brought lot of laurels in sports and cultural events nationally. I once again congratulate the students who are going to get their degrees today, and on the behalf of the CMR University, I wish you a great success and hope you keep your flag flying high. Thank you, one and all. Thank you. I request Honorable Visitor of the University to declare the convocation open.
The 7th annual convocation of the CMR University has been called to confer the honorary degree of Doctor of Letters and also to confer the degree upon the candidates who in the examination held for the purpose have been certified to be worthy of the same. I declare the convocation open.
I request the Honorable Visitor of the University that we have the honor to present you the Professor Ang Kyo An for the award of the honorary degree of Doctor of Letters. Professor Ang, please come forward. Honorable Visitor of the University, I have the honor to request you to award the honorary degree Doctor of Letters to Professor Ang Kyo An.
By virtue of the authority vested in me as the visitor of CMR University, I admit Professor Ang Kyo An to the honorary degree of Doctor of Letters.
I request the respected Professor Ang to address this august gathering.
This is my second visit to CMR University. My first visit was for the MOU between CMR University and Korean National Sports University. And ever since then, the two universities became a family. I am very grateful to stand before you to receive an honorary doctorate. From 1988 to 2019, I taught at the Korean National Sports University as a professor, teaching sports philosophy and aesthetics. And since 2019, I served as a chancellor of the Korean National Sports University. I am very honored to receive the honorary doctorate. At one of India's top schools, CMR University, this is such an honor that I cannot compare to other things. Today, I became a CMR alumnus. From now on, I will make effort for CMR University's development. Throughout my life, I never give up and try to do my best. I believe that life is like a marathon. And I will now run for CMR University. I'd like to thank Chancellor Dr. Savita Ramamurthy and the Chairman Sri Dr. Ramamurthy for this honorary doctorate. A person followed a fly, got to the toilet, while the other followed a bee, and got honey like this. I believe it is important who you meet and what decisions you make in life. I'd like to walk my path with CMR University and my chancellor and my chairman. Once again, thank you, chancellor and chairman, for this honorary doctorate. Thank you.
It is my pleasure to invite the Chancellor, Honorable Chancellor of the University, to administer the oath of integrity to the graduating students.
Let the candidates receiving the degrees rise. Now I will read out the CMR University pledge as candidates shall repeat after me. All candidates. As a graduate of CMR University, I will be a loyal ambassador of my university and my motherland, and shall scrupulously uphold the dignity and integrity in my professional endeavors to create the future that will drive positive global changes. This is my pledge. Please listen.
Presented.
Candidates receiving the degrees, please rise. Honorable visitor of the university, the candidates for the degrees of Doctor of Philosophy, Master of Business Administration, Master of Commerce, Master of Arts, Master of Social Work, Master of Science, Master of Laws, Master of Technology, Bachelor of Arts, Bachelor of Arts Honors, Bachelor of Laws, Bachelor of Arts and Bachelor of Laws, Bachelor of Commerce Honors, Bachelor of Business Administration and Bachelor of Laws, Bachelor of Business Administration, Bachelor of Business Administration Honors, Bachelor of Computer Application, Bachelor of Science, Bachelor of Technology, and Bachelor of Architecture are hereby presented, and all the remaining candidates of these degrees are presented in absentia. These candidates have been examined and found qualified for receiving their respective degrees. I pray they may be admitted to the respective degrees.
By virtue of the authority vested in me as the visitor of the university, I admit all the candidates presented to the degrees, and in token thereof, you have been presented with these degrees. I advise you to behave yourself in your speech and conduct befitting the degrees awarded to you.
Please resume your seats. The CMR University awards PhD degree, postgraduate degrees in 7 disciplines and undergraduate degrees in 8 disciplines. I have the honor to request the visitor of the university to present the degree certificates, rank certificates and medals to the recipients. I also request the chancellor, the chief guest, the guest of honor and pro-chancellor and other dignitaries to join. Now I call upon on stage the PhD degree holders, Mr. Nakul Subramanyam, to receive the Doctor of Philosophy in Management. Ms. Nagaratnamma J. Nagaratnamma Jay to receive the Doctor of Philosophy in Commerce. Mr. Chandra Prakash Dwivedi to receive the Doctor of Philosophy in Electronics and Communication Engineering. Mr. Basavaraj to receive the Doctor of Philosophy in Economics. Mr. Binni Cheriyar to receive the Doctor of Philosophy in Economics. Ms. Nancy Jacinta Katina to receive the Doctor of Philosophy in Mathematics. Ms. Deepika M. to receive the Doctor of Philosophy in Management. Mr. P.O. Martin to receive the Doctor of Philosophy in Social Work. Ms. Manchala Chilakamma to receive the Doctor of Philosophy in Management. Ms. Monisha Muliyil to receive the Doctor of Philosophy in Psychology. Ms. Shalini Acharya to receive the Doctor of Philosophy in Management. Ms. Mini Varghese to receive the Doctor of Philosophy in Education. Ms. Kusuma CM to receive the Doctor of Philosophy in Economics. Ms. Savita M. to receive the Doctor of Philosophy in Library and Information Science. Ms. Deepthi Das to receive the Doctor of Philosophy in Computer Science and Engineering. Mr. Rajas Subrapal to receive the Doctor of Philosophy in Management. Mr. Mithun B.N. to receive the Doctor of Philosophy in Computer Science and Engineering. Ms. Reshma Vijay to receive the Doctor of Philosophy in Management. Mr. Shambulinga B. Jali to receive the Doctor of Philosophy in Library and Information Science. Mr. Shibi Joseph to receive the Doctor of Philosophy in Journalism and Mass Communication. Mr. Suman Roy to receive the Doctor of Philosophy in Computer Science and Engineering. Mr. Rajkumar Baburao Nanavare to receive the Doctor of Philosophy in Education. Mr. Basavaraj S. Prabha to receive the Doctor of Philosophy in Computer Science and Engineering. Mr. Uttam Kumar A. to receive the Doctor of Philosophy in Computer Science. Mr. V.R. Sudarshana Raju to receive the Doctor of Philosophy in Computer Science and Engineering. Ms. Gauramma Halidodi to receive the Doctor of Philosophy in Computer Science and Engineering. Mr. Navalgun Nagaraj Raghavendra Rao to receive the Doctor of Philosophy in Management. Ms. Hrudaya VC to receive the Doctor of Philosophy in Management. Ms. Mary Lillian J. to receive the Doctor of Philosophy in Management. Ms. Aparna Shanai to receive Doctor of Philosophy in Computer Science. Ms. Shaini Rakhi to receive the Doctor of Philosophy in English. Ms. Anand Lokande to receive the Doctor of Philosophy in Management. Mr. Vivekanand J. to receive Doctor of Philosophy in Education. Ms. Roshini Jasmine to receive the Doctor of Philosophy in Management. Mr. Binoj S.S. to receive the Doctor of Philosophy in Management. Mr. Sumit Saha to receive the Doctor of Philosophy in Management. Now I call upon the first rank holders and the gold medalists. Ms. Rakshita P. to receive the first rank and gold medal in Master of Laws Commercial Law. Ms. Pooja Uma Shankar to receive the first rank and gold medal in Master of Laws Constitutional Law. Ms. Divya Shri R. to receive the first rank and gold medal in Master of Technology Data Science. Ms. Shweta Sudhil to receive the first rank and gold medal in Master of Science Psychology Clinical. Ms. Meghana Miriam Paul to receive the first rank and gold medal in Master of Science Psychology Human Resource Development and Management. Ms. Umate Varsha Dasharath to receive the first rank and gold medal in Master of Social Work. Ms. Saira Banu Kumbargeri to receive the first rank and gold medal in Master of Arts, Mass Communication and Journalism. Ms. Anusuya M. to receive the first rank and gold medal in Master of Commerce and ISDC gold medal. Mr. Sumanas to receive the first rank and gold medal in Executive Master of Business Administration in Product Leadership. Yes. Ms. Nikita Prabhakar to receive the first rank and gold medal in Bachelor of Architecture. Mr. Ariharan Y. to receive the first rank and gold medal in Bachelor of Laws. Mr. Gaurav Kumar to receive the first rank and gold medal in Bachelor of Arts and Bachelor of Laws Honours. Ms. Alonsa Arunav Sarkar to receive the first rank and gold medal in Bachelor of Business Administration and Bachelor of Laws Honours. Syed Afshana Hidayatullah to receive the first rank and gold medal in Bachelor of Technology in Computer Science and Engineering. Ms. Varsha SN to receive the first rank and gold medal in Bachelor of Technology in Electronics and Communication Engineering. Ms. Shri Shaila S. to receive the first rank and gold medal in Bachelor of Technology in Information Technology. Mr. Anjan Kumar to receive the first rank and gold medal in Bachelor of Technology in Mechanical Engineering. Mr. Raghavendra Telang to receive the first rank and gold medal in Bachelor of Technology in Civil Engineering. Mr. Z. Syed Zubair Ahmad to receive the first rank and gold medal in Bachelor of Arts Honours. Mr. B. Sabarish Swaminathan to receive the first rank and gold medal in Bachelor of Science Filmmaking. Ms. Trishak D. Barua to receive the first rank and gold medal in Bachelor of Science Photography. Mr. Abhijay Bandi to receive the first rank and gold medal in Bachelor of Science Sound Engineering. Mr. Abdul Khadar Khotwal to receive the first rank and gold medal in Bachelor of Science Visual Effects and Animation. Mr. Rushikesh S. Bhatt to receive the first rank and gold medal in Bachelor of Computer Applications, Game and Mobile Software Development. Ms. Priyanka Shobhi C. to receive the first rank and gold medal in Bachelor of Computer Applications. Ms. Leela Priya J. to receive the first rank and gold medal in Bachelor of Commerce. Mr. Harsh Raj Thakur to receive the first rank and gold medal in Bachelor of Commerce Honours. Ms. Ankita Rajan to receive the first rank and gold medal in Bachelor of Commerce honors in International Accounting and Finance. Ms. Pallavi Kumari to receive the first rank and gold medal in Bachelor of Business Administration. Mr. Umang Naresh to receive the first rank and gold medal in Bachelor of Business Administration honors. And the last one, Mr. Venkat Bharat Polideni to receive the gold medal for holistic development constituted by CBEDU for the outstanding student of the university for the class 2022. Thank you, sir.
It is indeed a great pleasure to me to introduce the today's recipient of Doctor of Letters. Professor Ang Kyu On graduated with a bachelor degree in physical education from Korea National Sports University and a master's degree in physical education in 1984. He obtained a ABD in aesthetics from Hongik University. He obtained a doctoral degree in physical education from Korea National Sports University 1994. In 2011, he acquired his second doctorate in philosophy from Korea University. He has profusely contributed in the sports arena, and he is currently heading the sports university, Korea National Sports University. I now request our Chancellor Madam to give the presidential address of the convocation. Respected Sri Hari K. Maharaj, I request you to speak few words on this convocation.
Good morning. Honorable Governor of Karnataka, Sri Thavarchand Gehlot ji, all the dignitaries on the dais, dignitaries of the dais, faculty, staff, graduating students, families of graduating students, and dear friends. I'm humbled and privileged to be invited to be part of this wonderful occasion. My heartfelt, first of all, let me start by expressing my heartfelt congratulations to all the students who have graduated. My best wishes to you for a fantastic future ahead. And I'd also like to extend my sincere congratulations and best wishes to Professor Yong Kyu An, the recipient of the honorary doctorate on the special recognition today. In a few days from now, you will step out of the hallowed portals of this great institution into an exciting world. I can't think of another point of time in my life when I felt more optimistic than I'm feeling right now. With much of the world staring at a crisis caused by ravages of war, climate change, inflation, and what have you that you're seeing nowadays, India seems to be the lone beacon of hope and optimism. In a world starved of growth, India seems to be relatively better positioned to navigate global headwinds as compared to most of the other major economies. And India has been and continues to remain one of the fastest growing major economies in the world today, with a GDP of $3.5 trillion. We're number five, and in the next few years, by the end of this decade, we will double that to become the third largest economy in the world. Bob Sternfels, the CEO of McKinsey, said, "It's not India's decade, it's actually India's century." This is a historic moment of time when optimism and opportunity have come together. I'm excited for you. And I'm excited about what you and your generation will do to help our country fulfill its true potential. In every direction you glance, there are opportunities galore. You have earned yourself a fantastic advantage by getting yourself this educational qualification from this wonderful institution. You have made one of the best investment decisions of your life. As someone who runs a large and varied business, one thing I've learned well is that you have to invest wisely to earn a good return, a good long-term return. The return you're likely to earn is directly proportional or is directly a result of the quality of the investment that you make. As you embark on this crucial phase of this journey of life, I would like to leave you with some investment advice. Like you've heard many times, while all investments are subject to market risk, here are four investment ideas that have helped me to manage my risks well and have stood the test of time. Number one, invest in continuous learning. What you've done so far and the education that you've earned so far is exactly what is required to start you off. However, the equity that you've earned so far of wisdom and knowledge and the learnings that you've accumulated so far, that equity is encashed the day you start your first job or the day you start your first business. Your future success depends on how you consistently build on that foundation to constantly reinvent yourself and continuously learn. Learning is a lifelong process. I have been a great beneficiary of the fact that I have developed over a period of time an unquenchable thirst for knowledge. I feel very uncomfortable when I hear something that I haven't heard before, and I'd like to learn up immediately on that. And I've recognized that over time, success comes from being able to peek around corners to recognize what's coming next, to be able to connect the dots, and to in connecting those dots, see patterns and see trends emerging. And that happens only when you learn continuously. And for that, I think something that's helped me and what I would recommend strongly to all of you is to develop learning habits. Firstly, develop as varied an interest in topics as you can. Do not remain unidimensional. Talk about technology, history, geopolitics, climate change, music, art, dance, the world of finance, investments, design, architecture, as wide as possible, I repeat. Secondly, make learning a daily habit. I focus on learning something every day, even if it's for 15 to 30 minutes, but learn on focusing something every day. And I feel that has great advantage because it makes learning easier. And more importantly, your transformation and your evolution is not sudden, but is gradual and continuous. And lastly, make it a point to develop your own personal perspective of everything that you learn. Now, everything that you read today, as you know, is not the ultimate truth or is not the absolute truth. It is the perspective of the person who's written it. So please learn to develop your own perspectives, discuss these perspectives with others, and keep an open mind to what others have to say, because ultimately it's this diversity that makes this world such a wonderful place. That brings me to the second investment advice. Invest in deep, meaningful, and long-lasting relationships. You've probably heard of the 80-year-old study that has been conducted at the Harvard University, where 268 youngsters, their lives were tracked over an 80-year period, with the idea as to reveal clues to good health and happiness. It revealed that close relationships, more than money, fame, or their other investments, are what kept people happy throughout their lives. I consider myself to be an incredibly happy and content man. And I believe it has come from having nurtured and fostered relationships with great care. And here is what worked best for me. Without doubt, family works first. Family comes number one, and don't forget that ever. We do household chores together. We talk openly together. We spend a lot of time talking to each other, play games together, and at least have two or three holidays together. Secondly, develop a group of friends who, as they say, will do anything for you. The number of friends do not matter, as you all know. It's the quality and the depth of relationship that matter. It is important to have a circle of friends like I have, with whom you can be your authentic self, and you can speak your mind without fear of being judged, and you know, in an atmosphere of unwavering trust. So we've spoken about family, we've spoken about friends, and lastly, develop and invest in formal and informal relationships at work with bosses, with subordinates, with peers. In tough situations and in times of crisis, I can assure you, it's the informal levers that are operated on the strength of relationships that will come to your rescue, and not the formal levers that are operated through command and control. So these relationships can come in really, really handy. And quite honestly, it's the best way to enjoy your work as well, because you're surrounded with people that you enjoy working with. Thirdly, the one thing that is, let's say, the most underrated and most ignored: invest consciously in your health. And I can't say I did that very well in my initial years, but I think over a period of time, this has been great learning. The most important thing about you right now is that you're alive and you're healthy. Of course, you would recognize that what consequence is success, fame, wealth, if one is not healthy enough to enjoy it. And what I have observed often and have undergone myself in the early years of my professional career is that the pressure to succeed is so intense that we end up deprioritizing health and fitness and focus all our waking hours on getting ahead in the rat race. I must confess of having fallen into that trap myself. I used to work 17 hours a day to a point till the system broke down and caused enough health scares to bring health back into focus once again. But unfortunately, it also left behind some permanent damage. So you could start probably a little earlier. The most often heard excuses: I don't have time to focus on fitness. I can assure you, each of us have exactly the same 24 hours in our timeline. What matters is how we allocate time. No time for exercise or fitness or health means only one thing: that it is not important enough to be prioritized over everything else. My personal health mantra consists of four golden rules. They're very simple. It's not rocket science. It's very simple and very easy to follow. One, exercise at least 30 to 40 minutes, maybe about 5 days a week. Eat fresh and healthy food. Most importantly, never skip a meal and eat on time. I eat my meals bang on time, come what may. Third, live a life of moderation. Do not deny yourself anything. Do everything as long as it's legal and moral, but do it in moderation. Do not deny yourself anything, all right? And last and most important thing, get yourself at least 7 hours of sleep. My family often jokes that it would take more than a sonic boom to wake me up when I go to sleep. But I sleep really well. I've just led and completed, as it was mentioned in the introduction, a 13,000 crore expansion program, which was completed in 4 years, out of which 2 years were one of the worst years that we've ever seen, the COVID years. And yet, these four mantras I never skipped during this period. Lastly, invest in acquiring varied experiences. You live only once. Make it count. When you're much older and look back at life, I can assure you that the only things that will count at the end are relationships and experiences that you've acquired over the years. Make your experiences, like your learnings, as varied as possible. Travel and explore the world. Get exposed to new cultures, languages, traditions, history. I came from a lower middle class house as a youngster, and my father, with his limited resources, made it a point to have at least 2 or 3 holidays every year. And that has given our family a treasure trove of memories that we can always look back. I think that's the greatest inheritance that our father has given us, that we can always look back at incredible memories. And these memories are what you will cherish over a lifetime. Needless to mention, the education and the exposure that it provided me comes in handy even today when you least expect it. Make adventure, wildlife, music, dance, theater, nature, sports, outdoor activities as a part of your life. And do this with family and friends, not alone. These things do not happen unless you put effort into it. So plan it into your annual schedule and make sure it actually happens. Ladies and gentlemen, on this milestone occasion for all of you, my wish and prayer for you is that you invest wisely, and may the returns you earn lead you to a prosperous, healthy, and very importantly, happy life. Your destiny is in your hands. You have had a terrific start in terms of the education at this absolutely world-class institute, which I get impressed with more and more as I spend time here. And you're now poised to enter a world that is pregnant with possibilities and opportunities. Go on and grab it. Make a difference to this world and create a legacy that no one can take away from you and will far outlive you. Good luck and Godspeed.
Honorable visitor of the university, I have the honor to request you to deliver the presidential address.
CMR University के सातवें वार्षिक दीक्षांत समारोह में मंच पर उपस्थित सीओ के प्रबंध निदेशक हरि के मरार जी, पूर्व राज्यसभा सांसद और मेरे अच्छे मित्र सहयोगी आदरणीय श्री के सी राममूर्ति जी, सीएमआर विश्वविद्यालय की चांसलर डॉक्टर सविता राममूर्ति जी, प्रोफेसर चांसलर श्री के आर जयजीप जी, प्रोवोस्ट डॉक्टर चित्रा राममूर्ति जी, वाइस चांसलर डॉक्टर एच बी राघवेंद्र जी एवं रजिस्ट्रार आदरणीय डॉक्टर प्रवीण आर जी, मानद उपाधि से सम्मानित कोरिया राष्ट्रीय खेल विश्वविद्यालय दक्षिण कोरिया के प्रेसिडेंट प्रोफेसर योंग क्यू आन जी, बोर्ड ऑफ गवर्नर, बोर्ड ऑफ मैनेजमेंट एवं अकादमिक परिषद के सभी सदस्यगण, सीएमआर यूनिवर्सिटी परिवार के समस्त सदस्य, विद्यार्थीगण, उनके परिवारजन, अन्य अतिथिगण, विशेषकर साउथ कोरिया से पधारे हुए सभी मेहमान, एल्लारिगू नमस्कारा। ತಮ್ಮೆಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಹಾರ್ದಿಕ ಅಭಿನಂದನೆಗಳು. ಮುಜೆ ಯೇ ಜಾನ್ಕರ್ ಕೆ ಪ್ರಸನ್ನತಾ ಹೋ ರಹೀ ಹೈ ಕಿ ಅಲ್ಪ ಸಮಯ ಕಮ್ ಸಮಯ ಮೇ ಹಿ ಇಸ್ ವಿಶ್ವವಿದ್ಯಾಲಯ ನೆ ರಾಷ್ಟ್ರೀಯ ಏವಂ ಅಂತಾರಾಷ್ಟ್ರೀಯ ಸ್ತರ ಪರ್ ಪಹಚಾನ್ ಬನಾಯಿ ಹೈ. ಅಪ್ನಿ ಯೋಗ್ಯತಾ ಕೆ ಆಧಾರ ಪರ್ श्रेष्ठ स्थान प्राप्त किया है. निश्चित ही आप सभी के सामूहिक प्रयासों का परिणाम है. आप सबने मिलकर के इस विश्वविद्यालय को ऊंचाइयां देने में अपना सहयोग दिया है. विश्वविद्यालय की कुलाधिपति डॉक्टर सविता राममूर्ति जी एवं सीएमआर समूह के अध्यक्ष डॉक्टर के सी राममूर्ति जी को मैं इसके लिए बधाई और शुभकामनाएं देता हूं, जिनके सार्थक एवं निरंतर प्रयासों से मात्र 30 वर्षों में ही सीएमआर शिक्षा समूह सराहनीय प्रगति के पथ पर है. इस दीक्षांत समारोह में कोरिया राष्ट्रीय खेल विश्वविद्यालय दक्षिण कोरिया के प्रेसिडेंट प्रोफेसर योंग क्यू आन ने खेलकूद गतिविधियों के लिए स्पोर्ट्स एक्टिविटीज को प्रोत्साहित करने में अपना अहम योगदान दिया है. इस विश्वविद्यालय को भी उनका मार्गदर्शन और सहयोग मिला है। मैं सीएमआर यूनिवर्सिटी के समस्त पदाधिकारी और वरिष्ठ जनों को इस बात के लिए बधाई देता हूँ कि खेल जगत को प्रोत्साहित करने वाले एक होनहार व्यक्तित्व के धनी को ऑनरेरी डिग्री देकर के सम्मानित किया है। वो इस प्रकार के सम्मान के पात्र हैं, मैं उनको भी बधाई और शुभकामनाएं देता हूँ। उनसे अनुरोध करता हूँ कि वो आगे भी देश और दुनिया में खेलकूद गतिविधियों को प्रोत्साहित करने के लिए जीवन भर सक्रिय प्रयास करते रहें। सफलतापूर्वक अध्ययन करने वाले और डिग्री प्राप्त करने वाले सभी छात्र छात्राओं को मेरी ओर से हार्दिक बधाई और शुभकामनाएं देता हूं, उनके उज्जवल भविष्य की कामना भी करता हूं। मुझे विश्वास है कि इस विश्वविद्यालय से प्राप्त गुणवत्ता पूर्ण शिक्षा और मजबूत नैतिक नींव आपके कैरियर को सफल बनाएगी और जीवन पथ पर आगे बढ़ने में सहायक सिद्ध होगी। जिस प्रकार से सीएमआर यूनिवर्सिटी ने अल्प समय में प्रसिद्धि प्राप्त की है, आप भी अपने कामों से प्रसिद्धि प्राप्त करने में सफलता प्राप्त करें, ऐसी मेरी भगवान से प्रार्थना है। जीवन की सफलता में शिक्षा का महत्वपूर्ण योगदान होता है और शिक्षा में भी कौशलता का महत्वपूर्ण स्थान है। व्यक्ति जीवन भर कौशलता प्राप्त करता रहे, इस प्रकार की महती आवश्यकता है और इसके लिए जन्म से लेकर के जीवन पर्यंत स्टूडेंट बने रह करके, विद्यार्थी बने रह करके परिस्थिति अनुसार शिक्षा प्राप्त करते रहना चाहिए। और अगर इस प्रकार की शिक्षा प्राप्त करने में हमको सफलता मिलती है तो हम हर क्षेत्र में, जिस क्षेत्र में हमारे काम की रुचि है और काम करते हैं, उसमें निश्चित रूप से सफलता प्राप्त होती है। मैं उम्मीद करता हूं कि आप जीवन पर्यंत कौशल व्यक्तित्व के धनी बने रहने का प्रयास करेंगे। हम सभी जानते हैं कि हमारी पुरानी शिक्षा पद्धति बहुत ही समृद्धशाली और विशाल थी और इसके कारण हम विश्व गुरु कहलाते थे। हमारा देश सोने की चिड़िया भी कहलाता रहा है, अर्थात शैक्षणिक दृष्टि से और धन धान्य की दृष्टि से यह देश पहले से ही सक्षम है। इसको और मजबूती देने की आवश्यकता है और इसे पूर्ण करने में आप अपना योगदान देंगे। हमारी शैक्षिक और सांस्कृतिक परंपरा अति प्राचीन है तथा वसुदेव कुटुंबकम के दर्शन पर आधारित होकर सर्वे भवन्तु सुखिना सर्वे संतु निरामया, ये सारा विश्व एक परिवार है और इस परिवार के सभी सदस्य सुखी हो, निरोगी हो, समृद्धशाली हो, इस प्रकार के वातावरण की आवश्यकता है। हमको इस दिशा में प्रयास करने की कोशिश करते रहना चाहिए। नई राष्ट्रीय शिक्षा नीति सर्वश्रेष्ठ शिक्षा नीति है। इसमें मातृभाषा, क्षेत्रीय भाषा, हम जहाँ रहते हैं वहाँ बोली जाने वाली भाषा को महत्व देने का प्रयास किया गया है। निश्चित रूप से इस नई शिक्षा नीति से देश के हर क्षेत्र के विकास में तेजी आएगी और देश में विकास की दृष्टि से तेजी लाने के लिए हमको प्रयास करने के लिए हमारे काम क्षेत्रीय भाषा और मातृभाषा में करने की आवश्यकता है। ये बात सही है कि ज़्यादा देशों में अंग्रेजी बोली जाती है, परंतु जो विश्व के विकसित राष्ट्र हैं वो विकसित कैसे बने इसका अध्ययन करेंगे तो एक बात समझ में आएगी कि उन्होंने अपनी भाषा में ही विकास कार्य किए हैं। जर्मन, रूस, चीन, फ्रांस, जापान, ये सब इसके उदाहरण हैं। विश्व में जो विकसित राष्ट्रों की श्रेणी में हैं, ये पहले नंबर से लेकर के 10वें नंबर तक आने वाले देश हैं। हम गंभीरता से विचार करें कि उन्होंने अपने देश की अपनी क्षेत्रीय भाषा में ये सब विकास कैसे किया, तो निष्कर्ष आएगा कि क्षेत्रीय भाषा के कारण विकास में किसी प्रकार का कोई अवरोध नहीं आता है। इसलिए हमको अपने देश की, अपने क्षेत्र की भाषा का उपयोग करना ही चाहिए, प्राथमिकता देना चाहिए। हर भाषा से प्रेम करने की आवश्यकता है, उसको सीखने की भी आवश्यकता है, पर प्राथमिकता हम जहाँ रहते हैं वहाँ की भाषा को देना चाहिए, ऐसा मेरा सोचना है। गौरवशाली और विकसित भारत के निर्माण में अगले 25 वर्ष अत्यधिक महत्वपूर्ण है। आज़ादी के 75 वर्ष हमने पूरे कर लिए हैं। अमृत महोत्सव के रूप में सारे देश में आज़ादी के 75 वर्ष की वर्षगांठ मनाई गई है। आने वाले ये 25 वर्ष हम सब लोगों के लिए अमृत काल के रूप में है और इस अमृत काल को अवसर के रूप में बदलने की ज़रूरत है, ताकि देश सेंचुरी मनाए, आज़ादी के 100 वर्ष का अवसर मनाए, तो दुनिया के देशों में सिरमौर स्थान पर हो, उच्चस्थ स्थान पर हो, इस प्रकार का वातावरण बनाने के लिए हम सबको सक्रिय सहयोग करने की आवश्यकता है और मैं अनुरोध करता हूँ कि आप इस दिशा में कारगर सहयोग करेंगे। अभी हमारे देश की ने आर्थिक दृष्टि से भी और हर क्षेत्र में प्रगति की है। G20 देशों की अध्यक्षता का भार भारत को मिला है। भारत इस G20 देशों की अध्यक्षता सक्षमता के साथ कर रहा है, सफलता के साथ कर रहा है और मुझे विश्वास है कि इसके कारण हमारे देश की अर्थव्यवस्था और सुदृढ़ होगी। आज हम विश्व के देशों में आर्थिक दृष्टि से 5वें स्थान पर हैं और इन बैठकों के माध्यम से जो हमको सलाह मिलेगी, प्रेरणा मिलेगी, वो देश को आर्थिक दृष्टि से भी और ऊंचाई पर पहुंचाने में सफलता प्रदान करेगी। मेरी विद्यार्थियों को सलाह है कि शिक्षा और खेल के साथ साथ ऐसे सांस्कृतिक कार्यक्रमों में भी बढ़ चढ़ करके भाग लें, जिससे आप शारीरिक और मानसिक और आध्यात्मिक दृष्टि से भी देश के अनुरूप सफलता प्राप्त कर सकें। पर्यावरण भी एक समस्या है हमारे देश में। पर्यावरण सुधार की दृष्टि से, जल संरक्षण की दृष्टि से हमको प्रयास करने की आवश्यकता है। आप इस प्रकार के कामों में योगदान देंगे तो देश की पर्यावरण सुरक्षा भी हो पाएगी। देश के विकास के योजनाओं में आप सक्रिय भागीदारी निभाएं ऐसा मेरा अनुरोध है जो आपने शिक्षा प्राप्त की है वो और लोगों को भी सिखाएं शिक्षित करें शिक्षा कभी चोरी नहीं होती विद्या कभी चोरी नहीं होती आपने जो सीख लिया वो जीवन पर्यंत आपके साथ जाने वाला है और आप जितना प्रचारित करेंगे जितना दूसरों को सिखाएंगे उतना अच्छा आपको कंठस्थ याद होगा और उसका लाभ आपकी प्रतिभा को सम्मान प्रदान करने में सहायक होगा ऐसा मेरा सोचना है मैं आप सभी को हार्दिक बधाई देता हूँ शुभकामनाएं देता हूँ और मेरी वाणी को विराम देता हूँ धन्यवाद जय हिंद जय भारत
I request honorable visitor of the university to declare the convocation dissolved.
I declare this convocation dissolved.
All may please rise for national anthem.
अधिनायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता पंजाब सिंधु गुजरात मराठा द्राविड उत्कल गंगा विंध्य हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उत्सल जलधि तरंगा तव शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभ आशीष मांगे गाहे तब जय गाथा जन गण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे जय 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 हे
Graduates, whoever have received your medals, you can collect your medal cases from here. audience, you can leave the hall and the refreshments is being served on the ground floor.